It demands its feed. It wants dope. That's why we walk down this white, white road. Eyes wolf hungry, sniffing for the flaming flowers. The light is white, gray, and lilac, and violet, like baby flamingos. It never gets dark here at night in June. White night, they call it. White night's red hunger. We look behind every whitewashed fence, hunting for the flames. Poppies, their fires explode here and there. They promise fire in our blood. The battles are devil's tongues, red flags. They dance on the inside of my eyelids. Chants of no need, a torn body overkill. We walk and search. We are on a mission. We are stealing poppies. We will make heroin at home. We will steal and run all night. We are in Steel Hill, 2 hours north from Leningrad. Here, I see them. I hop the fence and crawl between roses and raspberry bushes. The yellow horns and ivy flowers look sick, like me. Poppies split open. Their stems are silver green. I pull them out of the ground. Weakly, they sting me. Claws of clay claw their roots like monster hair. I run and hop back over the fence. A heap of poppies in my arms, like dying birds. We keep moving down the road. We don't say anything. The dogs are everywhere. We need more poppies. Red flames by the window. Philosopher jumps over the fence. I hear his feet stomping and a dog fears choke in his shed and growling. Someone in the house screams, junkies! And another woman's voice, junkies are here! I clutch the plastic bag with the poppies to my chest. Philosopher is fast. He flies back over the fence and lands on the white road, raising dust. We run, 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 past of the road into the field of grass and fall flat on our stomachs. I look at Philosopher. He laughs and winks at me, whispering, what doesn't kill us makes us stronger, right? We lay flat until the heat and voices die away. Keeps time, says Violet, and takes his words out. We brought just a little dope with us so we can last. Violet shoots first. He's easy. Can I go first? I ask Philosopher. I always ask. I love you, honey, he says, but no. He always says this. I wrap his shirt around his arm and look away. He takes forever to shoot. Faster, says Pilot. He's smoking now on his back, the timetable on his hand. Steel Hills, Leningrad, 5:38 a.m. The next train, 11:53. Come on, we have hour and we got work to do. His voice is slow. Ah, says Philosopher. He closes his eyes and falls next to Pilot. I wrap his shirt around my calf. My veins on my arms are gone. I only shoot into my legs. That's why they call me legs. I find the veins soon and feel the rush. Look at the sky, says Philosopher. Like God's eyes. He's watching us. He knows we are good. He loves us. I love God. I love life. I love Steel Hills. This field. Every motherfucking field. Every motherfucking blade of grass. This soil is like my mother. Motherland, get it? We come from the mother. We go to the mother. I love you, babe. I love you, Violet. Violet says, shut up. Cut. We get the blade. comes out. We cut the stems. The seed pods are not there yet. I slice the stem with my blade. Split it open and look. Cut, says Pilot. Vertically in parallel strokes. I know how to do it, I say. The sap oozes out. Above milk, dense, bitter. It smells like squished grasshoppers. I squeeze the silver stems, bruising them, milking them. Pilot enrolls surgical gauze. Gauze on the grass, milk on the gauze. The gauze thickens, turns brownish black like an old wound. The tears of the world, says philosopher laughing. Weeping poppies, you know that saying, the one who sees poppies weep will weep forever. Pilot wraps the gauze, packs it into the plastic and into his backpack. Let's get out of here, he says. The train will be here in 30. We're back on the road. We'll walk to the station. And then there is a fence. A hole in the fence is like a hole between teeth. We won't see it. Inside, there's a shack and a field of scarlet red, a sea of blood. Jump through the hole and go inside. We move from the side. We pick the poppies. Then I hear a click. I look up. A man with a rifle by the door. He's gray, shabby, ancient. Then I hear a click. I look up. And he has a rifle pointed at the philosopher. He looks like my grandfather. Put the flowers down, fuckers, he says. His voice is crackling, hissy. I fought the Nazis for you, Lord. He says, you're worse than Nazis, he says. How old are you? 16? 18? Waiting your life, he says. At 16, I was in a fucking trench. Put them down, I scream at philosopher. But he doesn't. He hugs the poppies close and rushes for the fence. And then I hear the shot. I see philosopher falling face down on the poppies. I see blood gushing. I stand there frozen. Flowers go and lift my arms up like in a movie about war. The old man's hands are shaking, the rifle jumps, and then he sees Pilot. He didn't see him before. He moves the rifle at him and shoots, laughing like a maniac. He has one tooth in his mouth, black and long. He shoots and all the bullets buzz by and no one is hurt except for philosopher, who doesn't move. Then the rifle clicks. There are no more bullets. Pilot puts his poppies down and walks to the man, his face twisted. He snatches the rifle out of the old man's arms and they fight for a second. I see the old man's skin stretching like rubber bands. Then Pilot hits him on the head. One time, two times, three times, and the man falls down with a sound. An old tree makes, and now he's on the ground, smashing poppies. All I see is a yellow foot with steep toes. I just stand there, mosquitoes singing in my ear. I can't move. Pilot throws the gun down and runs to philosopher. He turns philosopher around. I see blood on the side of his head. He's dead, I think. The words echo like in an underwater cave. But philosopher opens his eyes. His eyes are dark. He sits down and wipes the blood of his hand with his sleeve. It peels off his temple and flows down like scarlet butterflies. It's not blood. It's poppy petals. Hey, it's just a scratch, says Violet, touching philosopher's head. His fingers are so long, so slow. Let's move, says Violet. You're okay. We're fine. Philosopher looks around and sees the old man lying there. What happened, he asks. Is he dead? Fuck him, says Pilot. Let's get out before the cops come. Let's grab the poppies as many as you can. More, more. I pick up a heap of poppies. It is still only a nightingale sings. The mosquitoes whine in my ear. Now there's a chorus of them and they're loud. The time is like tar. The old man is lying there, his yellow feet spread in the bed of red poppies. We run back to the road, then to the field. We squeeze. into his backpack. That's it, he says. 5:30. We run on the road again towards the station. I hear the train. It's almost here. The sun is rising. Gold, huge. Then I see a small frog on the road. Then another one. Small, little, tiny, pale, gentle, golden brown. Dozens of them. They leap everywhere. Philosopher stops and crouches. Go, says pilot. The train. Wait, says philosopher. And starts moving the frogs into the gutter. On his knees, one by one. A dust cloud appears on the road. A car is approaching. Run, screams pilot. Cops! They're babies, says philosopher. The frogs in his hands. He starts crying. They're babies. Fuck you, says pilot. Grabbing my arm and dragging me to the train. We've got to go, babe, I say. Please. The train slows down at the station. The doors open and pilot pulls me inside. The glass doors close. I see philosopher. He's looking at me. Tears rolling down his gray cheeks. Behind him, I see a cop. A gun in his hand. The train jerks. It speeds up. I see philosopher falling.